Welcome back to CTV News Channel. I'm Jacqueline Mulcharek. Well, a new report is suggesting that many Canadian households are in the red. The average family debt in this country has reached $100,000 for each Canadian. The report by the Vanier Institute finds that the household debt-to-income ratio is at a record 150%. And that essentially means for every $1,000 in after-tax income, families owe $1,500. So what to do about all this debt? How serious is it? Let's talk to Kelvin Mangaroo. He is the president of RateSupermarket.ca. It's an impartial resource for people to compare rates across the country, and he's joining us in Toronto. Hi, Kelvin.
Hello.
So first, you know, it sounds scary when anyone says, I owe more than, you know, I'm bringing in. But I want to challenge you a bit. I mean, there is, many people make the point, good debt, bad debt. How do you see it? If you owe money on a mortgage versus owing money on a credit card with a 18-20% interest rate, there is a difference there, right?
Yes, absolutely. And I think the debt that a lot of people are concerned about is that higher interest debt. So that credit card debt that people might be getting charged 20, 25, 30%. And I think if that's growing at a faster rate, that would be more concerning versus the mortgage debt.
And a lot of people do see real estate as a good investment. So they're, you know, they seem to think it's okay if I'm heavily in debt for my mortgage. I'm going to get it back. My house is going up in value. We see a lot of foreign investors coming in and buying Canadian real estate as well. So obviously the issue comes up when rates rise. We know rates are going to rise. Any window that you can offer in terms of how quickly, how fast, what are we looking at?
Well, I think most of the major economists are saying that interest rates will start rising again maybe mid-2011. So we're looking around June, July time. And then they're calling for increases of 1.5 to 2% over the next 18 months to 2 years.
Mm-hmm. But the killer debt are the credit cards. So what are the basics on that? No matter what you owe, what are the steps you need to take to ensure you're not going to sink further and further into debt?
Yeah, well, that's the key. We've put together a 3-point plan there. And the first one is really review your current situation. So it's very helpful to sit down and kind of get a hold on and understand where your current debts are. So understand how much interest you're paying on mortgages, how much you're paying on credit cards and personal loans. And then once you're armed with that information, you're in a much better place to go out and kind of do something about it. And then the second point is set a budget. And I know it's very hard to kind of sit down and stick to that budget, but the key thing is to get a handle on what your income is, what your expenses are, and try and cut down those expenses back as much as possible, so that you have some money left over so you can try and reduce that debt. And I think the key point there is really try to start saving and stop the spending.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you know, it sounds like practical, logical advice. Where do most people falter?
I think it's one of those things, it's like a New Year's resolution. You're all ready to go at the beginning of January, then over time you kind of lose your will to keep going. So it's one of those things, set reasonable goals and do get a handle on what your current situation is and put a plan in place to pay off that debt that's realistic and that you think you can actually stick to.
Okay, and when you say pay off the debt, I mean, what are some real ways to just, when you say setting a budget, what are the big things that you can do to make a huge difference in setting a budget?
Well, I think the big thing is, again, get a realistic understanding of what your actual income is and what your expenses are on a monthly basis and see where you can cut back on some of that discretionary spending. So, going out for dinners and movies and that sort of thing. If you can cut that back and really reduce those discretionary costs, then you'd be, in a good position to start repaying those debts. And once you actually put a plan in place to start paying off that debt, there's a few things you can do to really help things along. So the first thing is identify that high interest debt and start paying that off first. So things like credit cards, where again you're paying 20-25% interest, start paying those things off. Another thing you can do is consider consolidating your debt. So if you have a few debts outstanding, you're paying high interest, why not look at getting a loan at a lower interest rate, consolidating those debts into one, and then start repaying that back as well.
Okay, Kelvin Mangaroo with RateSupermarket.ca talking to us. We appreciate it. Thanks.
Thank you.